I want to introduce you to a young man. And I mentioned to him just now, it was some years ago, we had a town hall meeting in Sandy Grande. And this young man, I think, came out for the first time there, or around the first time, there to speak. His name is Darren Sandy. And he's a veteran performer and spoken word artist. He's the current holder of the First Citizens National Poetry Slam title. That's a lot of words for saying he's among the best in the spoken word category, right? And he's artistic director of the Two Cents Movement. Congratulations, Darren. Darren will now share with us a poem titled A Day Without Corruption.
All right, thank you. I feel good to be here. Transparency is almost like my second family now. You know, from very early on in the process, we have been involved in doing spoken word poetry for them. And of course, thanks to First Citizens, not just for this opportunity, but for continuing to invest in spoken word poets. So let's go to the poem. Our Father, who art in heaven, please get rid of the corruption. Amen. And like any forgiven father towards a pleading son, at sunrise all corruption was gone. Yeah, just like that. A miracle pressed and packed into today. I did awake and there was no corruption. I heard a friend my age say that she now had to work hard to get her pension. She had to wait until she retired. I saw many fired as the custom of cunning customs caught on and the offenders were accosted and locked down. It was frightening. I had another friend was staring mad as he now had to take a test to get his license. It was enlightening how the families of those in high places now had to line up like normal citizens, even in the dark of night where things will normally go missing, like how drugs show up in a central police station just so well. That was never happening. It came, and it came abrupt, and who was not running from the law had to adjust. It was only then we found out that for a small island, we surrounded and submerged in the corrupt. Everything started to surface. From a SABGA report that was perched in the purses of perfect negligence to a municipal police posing with a full certificate from CXC that he never worked for himself. From a lawyer who did resurrect a dead man to sell land, corruption fled the land in what could only be described as a surreal occurrence. It was supernatural. As if moved by the rapture, it was fast and actual. Those endowed in corruption just started to disappear. The big fish drowned first in a depot of nepotism. Every contract secured before being procured was cured in the great disappearance from government officials to NGOs who never adhered. Once all of them started to disappear, there was no maxi to take because all the drivers were paired with double vendors and sole traders who will evade the tax by twisting figures and still act to raise price to profit margins. The police force went next for hiding colleagues who engaged in violence. State boards disappeared for all of the days of mismanagement. Journalists vanished for undue diligence as a headline worth more than a truth. And Facebook personalities disappeared because likes and views are worth public panic. Pastor, priest, and that thiefing mechanic. The sanitation man who left half the street with the garbage. The teacher whose camera was off for the whole pandemic. And the student who signed in and left his chair unattended. They were all gone. For every time we glance around, don't we see it? A bribe and unjust and under table dealing, as morals are now equated with feelings, and since everyone has a price, why worry fleeing this magical land where taking a witness stand is a death wish, where blowing a whistle is the key to a funeral hymn, where following due process means that you forever waiting, because unless you could bait her or bait him, then your ease of doing business in the waste bin. I say, Father, save my land. He say, boy, I waiting. I say, for what? He said, just as we picked it up, they could also shed their corrupt from the low to the top. Else we discipline in producing tolerance for our corrupt beings. I and all start feeling light and full of fear. Then I realized not even I believed in my nation. So I myself disappeared. And as my soul lifted over the land to pay for my unbelieving, I look back at the twin island. And when I look down, I saw only children looking up, wide-eyed, hoping to find a better future than mine. With the hope in their faces, I smiled and vanished.